Hello friends, in this video we will see one to all broadcast and all to one reduction. Now we have taken a ring of 8 nodes and we will see one to all broadcast on 8 node ring. In parallel computing, there is a need to transfer a message from one node to another node. Now for example, node 0 has message M that needs to be transferred to every other node in this ring. So there are many ways that node 0 can transfer message to other nodes. So we have to optimize this transfer. So one algorithm has been developed for 8 node ring to transfer a message at node 0 to all other nodes. So that's why it is called as one to all broadcast. So what has done here? If suppose node 0 transfers a message to node 1, and then node 1 transfers to node 2, and again node 0 transfers message to node 3, so there is multiple uses of same channel and it will make busy these channels. So we have to make optimum use of the channels. So the algorithm has been developed in that in the first step node 0 passes a message to other node, and then both of them, including node 0 and other node, these both will transfer the message, means they will become the sender. So see here, node 0 initially has a transfer of message to node 4, that is farthest from node 0. So now node 0 and node 4 both have the same message. Now both of them can be source. So in next step, second step, node 0 transfers message to node 2 and node 4 transfers to node 6. So second step is parallelly executed. Okay, now see, we are making distance half. So now next step is node 0 will transfer to node 1, node 2 will transfer to node 3, node 4 will transfer to node 5, and node 6 will transfer to node 7. So in 3 steps we see that all the nodes are having the message that was there initially at node 0. Now in the same way, all to one reduction, which is exactly opposite of one to all broadcast. Now see, in all to one reduction, each odd node, odd numbered node, will pass a message to nearby even numbered node. Okay, now one thing you need to know, that the direction is likewise, anti-clockwise, and in this case the direction is clockwise. Now in all to one reduction, so initially all odd numbered nodes will pass message to nearby even number node. So 7 is passing to 6, 5 is passing to 4, 3 to 2, and 1 to 0. In second step, the buffer at node 6 is collected at node 4, and buffer at node 2 is collected at node 0. And third step, we are having buffers at 4. Now at 4, how many buffers are created? See, message of 7 is collected at 6. Okay, now in this case message of 5 is collected at 4, and in this second step this will transfer 6th message and 7th message. So 4 will have 5, 6 and 7th message, and this last step will collect all the messages to 0. So at last 0 will have all other nodes messages. So that is called as all to one reduction on 8 node ring. Now we will come to hypercube. Now in hypercube it is three dimensional structure, so we have to see one to all broadcast on hypercube. Now there are 8 nodes in hypercube, whereby 0th node is having message M, and that needs to be transferred to all other nodes. So in first step, node 0 transfers message to node 4, then node 0 and node 4 both become source of message. In second step, node 0 transfers to node 2, node 4 transfers to node 6, and in third step, 0 to 1, 2 to 3, 4 to 5 and 3 to 7. So in three steps we find that all other nodes are having message which was there at node 0 initially. Hope you understood this concept. Thank you.